What is a cryptocurrency? And why are they important? In this short video, I'm going to explain the basic principles behind Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies and why they're so exciting. Ever since we've had the internet, people have dreamed of having a currency form of money native to the internet. E-money was going to be the killer app. And throughout the 1990s, a number of entrepreneurs made various attempts to build a digital currency. In fact, PayPal was one of these, originally conceived as a native digital currency for Palm Pilots. But digital currency is hard to do. The reason why is what we call the double spending problem. The wonderful thing about digital assets is that they're really easy to copy. You can make infinite copies of a Word document or a PDF, and each copy is an exact replica of the other. But this great advantage for digital assets is a big problem if you want to build a digital currency. If it's trivially easy to copy digital currency, users might try to buy two goods with one unit. They might try to double spend the money they own. This is a lot like counterfeiting problems that exist with physical currency. The attempts at digital currency in the 1990s solved this problem with centralization. They would introduce a trusted source that verified that each transaction hadn't been double spent. But this solution has its own problems. How much can we trust the trusted source? That central authority is a single point of security weakness. Both scammers and nation states could target the central authority to corrupt it or control it. In 2008, the pseudonymous Satoshi Nakamoto solved the double spending problem, and the Bitcoin network went live in January 2009. Bitcoin is a digital currency powered by what we call a blockchain, a chain of blocks of transactions strung together in a digital ledger. What's amazing about Bitcoin and all the blockchains that have come since is that they don't need a central authority to validate transactions. The network does that itself. To achieve this, Bitcoin uses a combination of cryptography, peer-to-peer networking, and economic incentives. None of these technologies were new when Nakamoto deployed them for Bitcoin per se, but in combination, they make an extremely robust and valuable economic institution. Open to anyone, virtually impossible to censor, and under the control of no central authority. We don't actually know who Satoshi Nakamoto is. Nakamoto may not even be one person, but a group of people. Nakamoto disappeared from the internet a few years after releasing Bitcoin and handed over development work to what is now the Bitcoin Foundation. But Nakamoto's invention, the blockchain and cryptocurrencies, has made us fundamentally rethink some basic questions about what is money and how we coordinate human activity. Because it turns out solving that tricky double spending problem has opened up an enormous amount of economic value and opportunity.